Hello and welcome everybody. J-Man here for another music reaction. I hope you are all doing well out there. So we have a new artist here. From what I'm being told by the requester, this was requested by Jess M81. John Farnham is the artist. Apparently he is a very beloved artist from Australia. Yeah, I'm surprised that I've not heard him. But then again, you know, I'm an ignorant American. For most of my life, all I heard was what was played on the radios and on, you know, major music platforms here in the U.S. So, yeah, I've discovered that there are a ton of bands and artists out there around the world that are absolutely fantastic that were never on my radar. So interested to check this one out. Let's go ahead. Let's dive on in. We got John Farnham and the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, You're the Voice. Let's get it. Looks like quite an old recording. Like 50 Cent? Come on, man. 80, okay.
We had the chance to turn the page over. We can write what we want to write. We gotta make ends meet before we get much
Quick pause here for first impressions. So, yeah, he's got a very nice voice and very, very much that sort of prototypical 80s sort of a sound going on here. His voice, I love the texture and the grit to his voice. It's a little, not like he sounds like him, but the vocal styling is reminiscent to me of like a Bryan Adams sort of a thing. He's definitely got some pipes, man. He's got some really good pipes, and I'm feeling like we're probably going to get even a better taste of that as the song moves on here. It feels like we're sort of building up to something, but great vocals, very cool. Let's back it up a smidge and keep on going. That part right there, that's what makes what sounds reminiscent to a Bryan Adams kind of thing.
Make it noise and make it feel.
bagpipe, right? Definitely the 80s. Audience participation. We're not gonna sit in silence. We're not gonna live with fear. We're not gonna sit in silence. That was an abrupt ending. So yeah, definitely his voice is very powerful. Definitely enjoyed his voice. I was also thinking there near the end that there were parts that were reminiscent of like a David Coverdale from Whitesnake. Just the whole song was dripping with 80s vibes, right? A very 80s balladish sounding song. The vocal stylings remind me a lot of the vocalists from the 80s, things like that. But yeah, there's just a unique texture in his voice that is just really, really cool. I love an artist that's just sort of, it seems like it's just sort of a natural gravelly sound in his voice. He's not really trying to add texture to his voice by, you know, manipulating his larynx or anything like that. It just feels like and sounds like it's just a natural sort of a gravelly sound to his voice. So yeah, really enjoyed that. Thanks so much for the request, Jess. I hope you enjoyed the reaction. YouTube, let me know what you thought in the comments down below. That'll be it for music reactions for me today. We'll be back tomorrow for a few more. So I hope to see you for those. Till we see you next, stay safe. Peace.